Israelis. Even. Why? Because of America. Why? Because Israel is their lovely baby in the area.
So basically, now it's like chaos and hell in Gaza. No medicines, no supplies. They're killing kids, children, women.
Genocide.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And close the door.
Ini adalah kesempatan dan kehormatan yang luar biasa karena di depan saya ada Palestinian Ambassador to Indonesia, Your Excellency Dr. Zuhair Aljun. How are you, sir?
I'm okay. Thank you.
Thank you for coming. It's such an honor.
It's my pleasure.
For me. You know the traffic in Jakarta, so I know that you come here a lot of effort.
I think 1 hour, 10 minutes from my place, yeah, till I reach this area.
Yeah. Well, anyway, thank you. It's such an honor for me that you come to the podcast.
Thank you.
However, we know what we're going to talk about, but I want to start it from the end of the podcast, which means that I want to ask you these questions. Do you have anything that you want to say to Indonesian people regarding the situation now?
For sure that lovely people.
Lovely people. One,
yeah. And we are proud of them. Indonesian people is always standing and supporting Palestinian wherever in the all organization, political issues, economically, you know, even in social. And we do appreciate. Already we have listened to your president, His Excellency.
Yeah.
And we got his message, as well as the diplomacy lady, Marsoudi.
Yeah.
And other officials, defense minister, parliament. So I can say that Indonesia, they are in our heart. Palestinian, wherever they are talking about Indonesia. Indonesia is more improvement in supporting Palestinian than others. This is what I can say.
Thank you very much. That's amazing. It's lovely to hear it from you. Now, in all social media, and I think every Indonesian people, they believe that we might have a role. We believe that we might have a role to bring peace to these situations. But I really like to ask you, is that true, or is it possible that Indonesia can have a role for bringing the peace to the situation?
For sure, I agree with you. Indonesians, they are fighting with us to reach for peace, for settled all issues in Palestine. It's written in the constitution of Indonesian, you know, that they are not feel sufficient unless they will see Palestine free.
Yeah.
And even His Excellency message that we have to end this stupid war.
Stupid war.
Yeah,
stupid
crazy war.
It's crazy.
And then we have to see what's behind this conflict. We should work for reaching peace. This is our message, you know.
Yeah.
And even Indonesians is the same feeling, the same objective that they are looking to be, I mean, peace and the land of peace, Palestine. To live everyone side by side. But unfortunately, Israelis' mentality is different. That's why this is conflict is more than 75 years now.
Yeah. Is this the biggest one? Is this the biggest war that we have here this time?
Yes. But I'm saying it's more than 75 years we are under the occupation. So Indonesia, as well our leaders, is looking for peace. Indonesia is working to keep that land and peaceful area.
But do you think it's powerful enough that what Indonesian's government do or country do?
They are trying. Now, the committee of all foreign ministers by Islamic Arab summit recently in Saudi Arabia, they have moved to China, to Russia, to UK, to France, Europe. Marsoudi, the foreign minister, one of this committee. Yeah. So they are trying to end this conflict, to stop the war, to get the victims, the people who are suffering in Gaza, receiving the medical aid, assistance, other necessary. And then they are working that, let us see how to solve this political issue. It's not only humanitarian.
Political, no. You said political issues.
Yeah.
So it's not only humanitarian. Political issues.
Political issue.
Because you told me here before that what is behind this stupid war? You said that. So may I ask you, what is actually behind this stupid war?
For sure, when you see for more than 14,500 more, half of them children who are still looking to growing for life have been killed. It's a crazy war. It's a crime. What Israel is doing, it's a genocide against Palestinians. This is my statement. So everybody, see in all over the world, demonstrations. Yeah. Against whom?
Yeah.
Against Israel, against the policy of USA, who are supporting this aggression.
So you're saying that this is a war crimes?
I can say that this is crimes. It's committed by Israel, number one.
Committed by Israel?
For sure.
Okay.
There is who supporting Israel.
And those who are supporting Israel? In those countries,
USA is very clear, and some European countries also behind that. If they are, concerning this issue, they can ask Israel to stop, and they are able. Who's supplying
the guns, the weapons?
Israel, the weapons. Who? Who's giving them support? Who's dealing with them? Always I used to say Israel should be isolated and more sanctions should be taken against Israel instead of opening the doors and the gates to deal with them.
Yeah. This is I don't think this is a secret anymore, isn't it? This is no secrets anymore that some country are helping Israel, supporting Israel.
It's clear. It's clear in the UN Council. Three times ceasefire failed. To reach for taking decision, resolution for that. Why? Because of America.
And why?
Why? Because Israel is their lovely baby in the area. And they are dealing that Israel is their plan and their project. How Israel is establishing that part? Israel was not more in Palestine. It has been established in 1948.
Mm-hmm.
But we are there more than 6,000 years before. So that's why, America and some European countries, before declaration, who gave this promise to Zionism? Britain, number one, with the help of USA, with the support of USA and other parts of European They need to remove the Jew or the Israelis from their sites to keep it somewhere. By the way, and it's not secret also.
It's no secret.
They offer Zionism to establish their country in Uganda, where the lake, Victoria Lake, second in Europe, third in America Latin. But Zionism leaders refuse. One day I asked President Museveni of Kampala, Uganda. He said, that's true. It has been refused, but they choose Palestine. So this is the...
So there's a war behind the war. So this is like America versus Russia, China? Am I right saying that or not?
All who consider and recognize Israel in 1948, they are supporting Israel. All countries. Russia, number one, recognized Israel in 1948. Okay, now their policy is in balance, that they need Palestine to be free and to get their independent state according to the 1967 border. It means 22% of our historical land.
Mm-hmm.
And we give them 78%. 56 by General Assembly Resolution and UN 181. And then 22, they have committed massacres against the vigilers and cities there. And then they took 22% more. The rest is 22, which is West Bank, Gaza,
West Bank,
as well as East Jerusalem. And they are not accepting. So let us ask the international community what they are doing. Why they are absent? Why in Ukraine, all they have moved in one time against Russia?
Yeah, that's true. Well, if you're talking about Ukraine, there's a war in Russia with Ukraine, but it's not like this. It's no genocide. They don't kill children. I don't know, but I think that's what I see.
Well, you know, this question can be asked by the Biden and his administration or European part. They are talking about two-state solution. Israel have been considered by them, but state of Palestine is still not being recognized by these countries who are behind Israel, unfortunately.
Okay.
They are cheating the public. If they are serious in supporting two-state solution, why they are not recognizing a state of Palestine border 1967? Clearly, they are afraid? No. Because this is their policy.
They're not afraid, they just don't want it. They're not afraid, but they just don't want it.
Yeah.
They don't want to accept it.
It seems like that. This is what I believe.
Okay. What about the situation now that they're blaming Hamas for this?
Hamas?
Yes.
Hamas, you know, it's a part of Palestinian, community.
Yeah.
And they are fighting, as we are fighting, everyone is fighting against Israeli's aggression.
But is that become their reasons right now, right? They're blaming Hamas.
Why?
As a reason for Israel.
Why?
Attacking.
Why? Who's the victim on the ground? Who are suffering? Who are sacrificing on the ground? Israelis? No. Never. 75 years we are under the occupation. Why we are fighting? Just for fighting? We need to kill? It's not true.
Yeah.
It's not true.
That's I understand. But what I mean is that they're using that as a reasons.
They can talk whatever they need.
Ah, okay.
They can talk whatever they need to blaming him, but it's not true. It's not true. My friend, see what's happening now in Jerusalem, in West Bank. Settlers, what their activities are doing. Gaza is sieged. The people, they will remain like that. Mm-hmm. They will raise their hands. They will keep silent. It cannot be. It cannot be. So they are having the right, as every Palestinian is having the right, to struggle and to continue struggling till we become independent.
Okay.
Yasser Arafat, rahimahullah, he accepted Oslo Accord. He was with Ishaq Rabin, near to be, to reach for ending this conflict. When the extremes party in Israel come to know, they killed Rabin.
Yeah.
And the circle become to the zero till now. They don't need peace. This is what I believe.
They don't need peace.
For sure.
They don't want peace.
100%. Who are committing and trying to do this in the ground? Do you think that he is looking for peace? Never. In case there is any conflict, it can be solved. But not in this way. Killing the people like that.
Yes.
Destroying the houses where they are sleeping. They are looking for peace?
No.
Never. And this is not the first time. If you go back to the history.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
In 1948, massacres in Deir Yassin, Kafr Qasim, in Sabra Shatila, Sharon, what did he commit? In Jenin City, in Jenin Camp, and then Gaza. Gaza, this is not the first time.
It's not the first time. Yeah.
Four times before.
This is the worst, right?
This is the, for sure.
This is the worst.
That's true. What they are doing now, and all the people are seeing. I'm talking about officials, yeah. Politicians. But the, if you watch whatever happening, even in USA, citizenship,
yeah.
UK, demonstration.
They don't
against their governments, because no one believe, no one can believe.
Yes,
what's happening? No.
But there must be. I asked you this before, and you say, "Yeah, there may be Israel, but there is must be things that they aim, right? What is that? What do they want?" Just to destroy Palestine? Is that what they want?
I think so.
Or this behind that, what do they want?
I think so. Israelis, extremes, ideology, they need the land. And they don't need anyone except Jew in that part. This is not only strategy. They believe on that. They don't want to see any more Palestinian. Why? We are asking them.
Yeah, that's my question. Why?
For sure. We are asking them to reach for initiative for any peace treaty.
Yeah.
To be together. We accepted you in my home. And you are asking me to leave my home. Cannot be. So, if you go back 40 days before, when this conflict started, North Gaza completely demolished. And they asked the people to go to Sina, Egypt part, into the south. But for sure, Palestinians refused to be another Nakba. Which is 1948.
Yeah.
Because this is Israel's planning too. The alternative country for them, alternative place for them. This is what they are thinking to do, but it's not easy. Palestine on the ground is more stronger than them.
Yeah, that's
why. Even whatever technology is having, whatever weapons is getting from here and there.
Yeah, that's why they're bombing.
Because we are having the right.
Yeah, that's why they're bombing it from the air.
That's true.
Oh my God. But what is the...
Yeah.
Oh, this is really hard. So what is actually the conditions right now? Because we see the conditions from the social media.
What do you think? You know, leave the social media. More than 40 days crimes. What do you think the situation on the ground? The people are suffering. What is coming from social media is 10% on the fact. If you will go and you suddenly you see the Buddhists on the street.
And they're not army. Yeah?
No.
They're civilians.
Civilians.
Kids, children.
Kids, women, old, civilians. No military or arms people have been killed during this aggression.
What?
I'm sure. The 14,000 and more, most of them civilians from Gaza.
No military.
Military and other who are fighting, they are under the ground. They are not able to reach them. And they know. See, since they have entered North Gaza, more than 75 soldiers and high level also have been killed from Israeli side. How? Suddenly they used to come out and,
and
did the operation. And then they go again. Israelis, even what kind of crimes committed. But Israel, in bad position. Inside
again?
Israel as well as outside.
Sorry, again? You say Israel is in a bad position?
Bad position. What they are doing. See the people, how they are.
Yeah, they're
talking right about that. Even America, their dignity is down.
There's no humanity.
Humanity, yeah. Biden and this state minister, foreign minister of the United States, they came there, they said, we are Jew. Oh my God. You know, all president of USA, when they leave the power, they start talking in different way. But we are in the power. The story is always behind Israel. Unfortunately.
What do you think with the world attentions today, supporting humanity in Palestinians, do you think this can stop the fight, the war? This can stop Israel with all the demonstration. Even what I heard is even in Israel itself, there's a demonstration to stop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everywhere. Israel and USA, all parts of the world.
Yeah.
Who are looking for a humanitarian law and humanitarian dealings.
Which is so funny because they're Israeli citizens and they want to stop the war.
They want to stop. They want to stop. Some of them, I know, they are not always looking for war. They need to live in peace. I met some when I was in Palestine. I know that. Some of them, they are thinking. But the extreme and these settlers who are thinking always to create this conflict. But anyhow, according to your question, if occupation is not over, conflict will remain. again and again. But now, for example, ceasefire.
Yes, now it's for 3 days.
Temporary. 4 days.
4 days.
4 days. To release these prisoners, 50, 150.
But the
ceasefire
is just, it's not stopping the war. The ceasefire means they're going to, people are going to kill
occupation
people.
Occupation is the main problem. End of occupation. Reach for real solution. According to the international regulation and law. My friend, Israel established according to one resolution. 181. This is the birth certificate of Israel. And the resolution says 56 for Israel, 54 for Arab Palestinians. Yep. Over. Why this is implemented? Second, till now is suffering. And the people are suffering and no respond from United States and others. But once you recognize one, deal with the second part. To make the area that it, peaceful.
Yeah. But that's not happening before, up until now, right?
Yes.
So do you think the ceasefire is just a ceasefire? It's not going to stop?
As I said,
is that a hope that
ceasefire now can help to give more humanitarian assistance?
How about negotiations in the ceasefire?
No negotiation. Okay. Qatar is trying to make something with the Egyptian side. They have reached for that. Because, you know, everyone is worried.
Yeah.
All the international is worried. What's happening? And we are not able to stop. Why we are in the chair? You see, Palestinians, they are Arabs, Muslims, Christian.
Yeah.
And all the people all over the world,
yeah,
either Arabs or Europe. Jesus, his message started from Palestine. He born there. He's Palestinian citizenship. And see how many people all over the world following his message.
Yeah.
Where is the international law and regulation? Hopefully, that peace in the land of peace. Palestine is the holy land. And we are working for reaching for that.
So who can make this happen?
Well, if the international community can work hard and Israel's part, they are ready. And new leaders, they can accept it. I think things can be done.
And I think you're also right that this war actually, okay, if you're talking about humanity, it kills a lot of people in Palestine. But for the names of the country itself, not everybody like doing demonstrations hates bad names for Israel.
That's true. Because all demonstrations
can be bad for them.
It's against Israel. But these people, you know, I think that they don't feel. You know, as I am a man, I think on life. If anyone abusing me, I cannot sleep.
Yeah.
But Israel, every day, everywhere, in every corner of the world.
I I don't know how to answer you.
So they are. They don't care if they will kill, damage. They don't care. Only they have to be.
How is it possible?
Controlling.
How is it possible? I don't get this. How is it okay? How is it possible? And how those behind this let that happen, killing children? How is it? What can make people like that?
Because of absence of injustice. If there is justice on the earth, I think things will be changed. Either from UK or USA or France, wherever, injustice is absent.
Yeah, but war is not like this. War is military against military. War is taking the place by taking the governments, not by killing kids. And
this is politics, interest, benefits, how they are thinking.
Make them able to do that.
For sure. For sure.
I mean, I also heard the electricity, water supply, humanitarian aids are very restricted now in Gaza.
Nothing is available on the ground.
Not available?
Not available at all.
If you say not available, so how people there survive?
They are managing themselves, you know, in different way. Some families, they used to go and to prepare some foods to give neighboring. They used to go to the Mediterranean Sea to bring water from the Mediterranean Sea to drink. Electricity, all hospitals is out of order.
And the medicines and everything.
Yeah. So, situation is worst on the ground.
How about the Arab League?
You know, Arabs, okay, we're getting support. And they don't want to see this stupid
war.
And they need to reach for a solution. Because as I told you that, everybody is worried. In the region, everywhere. Because in politics, nothing can be stable.
Yeah, you're right.
Movable.
Yeah.
So Arab countries, they are trying.
But it's not that easy because there's a politic behind this.
For sure. Trying, getting support, approaching other countries all over the world. This is what they can do.
That's all they can do.
This is what they can do.
Mr. Ambassador, just out of my curiosity, do you still have family over there?
Yeah.
Do you have family?
I have family. It's with me here in Indonesia.
Mm-hmm. Is that any friends or family that become victims over there?
My brothers, sisters, they are in West Bank, Tul Karim city. The city have been attacked yesterday.
Mm.
And 7 have been martyred there. And the 12 martyred before 3-4 days, Tul Karim city. My sisters and brothers are there, family. My house is there. In Gaza, I have friends. I have who are carrying my family also in Gaza. But I don't have any information.
No contacts at all?
No contacts. No contacts.
Is that not possible because you're an ambassador here in Indonesia? Is that possible to using your power or your whatever it is, political way, to bring your sister or brother from there to Indonesia? Is that easy or not?
No. It's easy if I can invite them and arrange everything for them according to the regulation. They can come and they can visit. But why? We don't want.
You don't want?
For sure. We need to keep our people in the ground, on the land.
Even the race is killed?
No, it's not like that. But Israel is trying that. Let Palestinians to move out, to go out of the...
But staying there are dangerous.
Everybody's dangerous. They don't want to leave the land.
They don't want to leave
there. They don't want. We'll kill there, we'll die there. This is what they believe. As I told you from the beginning, we'll not repeat 1948 Nakba.
Because this is their land.
That's true. And we are having the right for that.
Wow. And your brother and sister in the West Bank?
West Bank, yeah.
Okay. Is there any tensions in the West Bank? About the war? Is that affecting?
No, they are safe.
They are safe.
They are safe. They are safe.
Is that possible that it goes to West Bank?
It's there, daily. Daily aggression. Jenin City, this morning, few days before Jenin City, Tulkarm City, Nablus City, everywhere, in Hebron yesterday, Jericho.
But you say they're safe there.
Safe, what to do? This is our life. We have to be like that. Anyone can be killed. Anyone moving, going, coming, by settlers on the street.
So there is already aggression to the West Bank?
For sure.
And you say that they are safe there?
They are safe. What I mean safe, I mean my family is okay, I mean have not been affected, but no one is safe for long period.
Wow.
When I'll go back to visit my family, maybe while I'm going in the street, by car, once settlements, if he need to make any problem or shoot the car, it's over.
We can do that.
It can be, yes.
Can be, yeah.
And happened. Happened for others. This is our life there. Not safe, as you mean safe. No.
So basically, everyone there are very patriotic. They don't want to move. They don't want to leave the land. If they die, they die there. Yeah. It's their destiny, and they're looking for freedoms and for...
We are looking for to be free. We are working for independent. And...
Okay, Mr. Ambassador, maybe I can ask you this from your perspective. What is the most effective things that us Indonesian people can do to support Palestine now?
If I need to talk about officials and high level, for sure that to work for end of occupation.
Yeah.
This is number one. Indonesian, as well as the president and others, they know very well their responsibilities. Mm-hmm. And they are working according to that. Whatever is coming from Indonesia is really more than enough.
You're saying from the government part. What from
government
the citizens,
as well as the public.
As well as the public.
Yeah. Public's daily visiting me in the embassy. Hundreds daily. Not only message of support. Ready to give anything for Palestine. So, who are following the file in the embassy and receiving the guests who are coming. Minister is coming. Businessman is coming. Woman is coming. Religious leader is coming. Schools is coming. Every NGOs since 40 days, you cannot believe. So this is Indonesia.
when we try to help your country by donations, well, donation can be money, can be stuff, right? Is that true that it is hard to get inside Gaza? The donations, is that easy to go inside to Gaza? Or is it very difficult?
No. It's not difficult.
It's not difficult.
It's not difficult. Our authority and Ministry of Finance, whatever is getting all over the world, they are managing for all arrangements, for hospitals, for the people, for construction, for their lives. But if ceasefire is there, because Israel, while controlling, and you know that,
yeah,
in Al Arish airport, many flights is landed there. Indonesia, two flights sent it by officials and yeah, by business and NGOs and businessmen, etc. It has been landed there.
But
they cannot go inside if the war is continuing bombing, because they have to be safe to send the medical aids, whatever, fueling, etc.
So until now, is
they are sending, but not that large of number to keep them more enough.
Sorry. So they're sending, but inside Gaza, is it?
Okay? Inside Gaza, yeah, through Rafah border. Through Rafah border.
But not that
not
much.
Not that much. Which, I mean, not that capacity is needed.
Why? Because it's going to get
because
shot?
Because of the war, attack, and bombing. And UN UNRWA is receiving to send for the people. If they are not safe, how they will start distributing and going from part to part? This is the case.
So basically, now it's like chaos and hell in Gaza. No medicines, no supplies. They're killing kids, children, women.
Genocide.
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 My last question, Mr. Ambassador. First, thank you. It's just an honor again
for it's my coming pleasure. Here.
And hopefully this can reach a million of people in Indonesia to hear the truth about this. Yourself. Personally yourself. What is your hope now?
My hope.
I'm not talking about the government side.
That's okay.
Your hope.
My hope, to see my children as everywhere the children are living and feeling the, how is the life?
As simple as that.
Yeah. This is what I'm looking for. To live in peace. We're human beings. All belong to God. And God is the owner of all properties on the earth. Why should not think properly and use our mind for our generation, for all generations in the region? Why killing? Why? So my hope, to go and to come without any disturbance. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Palestinian Ambassador to Indonesia, Your Excellency, Dr. Zuhair Alsun. Thank you very much for coming.
It's my pleasure. Thank
it's
you
an honor.
Much.
It's such an honor. Thank you. Let's close this.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And close the door.